It's a pleasure to be here, and it's part of my celebration. I celebrate every day because it's the first day of my life, and I share with people we all have that in common. You have reason to celebrate the fact that you live another day, and it is truly the first day of the rest of your life, so I celebrate all the time. However, this next week, I'm gonna be 86 years old, so that's a particular celebration, which this is a part of, so I can smile all the way through it. And I try to smile. I recommend to people that smiling is easier on your face than frowning. So I prefer to smile. I prefer love over hate. Those two things kind of go together. So I smile wherever I go. Try to bring good cheer to people so that they recognize that being an aerospace engineer, we did a lot of things in space, but we can be kind to human beings here on Earth. And that's a part of my life story, is sometimes I feel a little bit disappointed that our human relations didn't keep up with our aerospace progress. But nevertheless, we're still doing better, more diversity. I see more women doing things now than ever. What you're doing now in the past will be done by men. So I appreciate diversity in terms of ethnic minorities, females, etc. In our world. I see more of that. It encourages me to continue to inspire and provide optimism by way of experience to young people. The project that I'm known for is the development of a application of a camera system to the Apollo program. Goes back to when I was 30 years old. And the unique thing about that is that my general experience was in an area of producing hardware products for rocket propulsion systems, engines, like the engine in your car. And what I was being asked to do at this point in time was a different area. It was like, do something that was associated more with the instrument panel so you can monitor things. So the purpose of this camera system was to monitor, and that was a new avenue in my career. As a matter of fact, the project had been assigned to a senior engineer by my supervisor at the time. This individual happened to have been 55 years old, I was 30. And for some reason, I was asked to do the task instead of him because I had a can-do reputation. I was the kind of a guy that would take a task, and I wasn't afraid to take the challenge. So as I worked on that several years, beginning in 1965 timeframe, which happened to be the same year that civil rights, I happened to go to participate in the voter registration that famous summer after the Selma March. We then set up voter registration for the entire summer. So I worked on that in parallel with my aerospace. And over the next several years, as I worked on the development, getting this installed and so forth, and the basic purpose for this camera system was we had many, many engineers who had evaluated the separation of the vehicle. And in the past, it had some problem with separation. The separation of this vehicle, it was 33 feet in diameter. It had bolts all around, explosive bolts that had to detonate and come apart cleanly. And when we finished the analysis, NASA did not quite have 100% confidence in the results of the analysis. So they essentially provided cameras so we can show them that it worked well. And that's what I worked on. So as we went on to fly that mission that showed the separation, the coincidence of that mission, Apollo 6, which happened April the 4th, 1968, was the same day Martin Luther King was assassinated. So I have a parallel with my aerospace career and civil rights and equal opportunity for people. And the nature of that film that came back was the first time we had really flown high enough and take pictures that we saw the Earth's curvature. So not only did we prove the separation, we demonstrated that the Earth curvature was there, so the Earth was round. And as we flew later on, we flew high enough to see the entire globe. But this was one of the first, and that's why this particular flight and those photos became iconic. So of all the things I did in my entire career, I tapped into this because of the nature of it. Everybody has seen it. I actually worked another 30 years in my career after that. This occurred at 10 years in a 40-year career. In my last 15 years, I was an executive at the executive level, vice president level. And however, I became known more for what I did at age 30 than what I when I retired at age 60. And so by virtue of that, I'm also proud of the fact that I was the first black on what we refer to as Mahogany Row, where the executives were, and my last 15 years were spent there. Left to my own devices, I would have defined that as my career highlight. But the separation became iconic on its own, so I tapped into that. So that's who I am, that's okay. the beauty of having decided to have implants, many of my friends went through and they put dentures in various things. And I decided that of all the investments that I ever made, this was one of the few things I can take with me. So the investment, not only was it more beautiful, it's something I will not leave behind. And the nature of that, being a mechanical engineer and an aerospace and all these things, I have had just all kinds of fun with my aerospace friends, mechanical friends, people who worked on automobiles. When I share the video of them torquing my teeth in, they take the wrench, and I have a video of that I share. So not only do I take photos of my teeth, the substructure, I show them torquing the teeth in. And that, as a part of the process, really lends to the results, the fact that I have a smile that is to live for. We used to say to die for. Well, I don't die for anything, I live for it. So this smile is to live for. I owe a debt of gratitude to Trust Dental. You are an integral part of my life. I recommend people here, when they see me smile and they know I've made that investment that I can take with me, it is a winning proposition.